Hey people, Paul Michael here. Today is August 10th, 2011, right? People, the moon is huge. It's right there, remember? On the 8th, today the 10th. On the 8th, I showed you all the moon was 3/4. People, now it's almost full. Okay, the cloud, I didn't get it in time because my dog was... I was trying to get the dogs inside because it started to rain. And the moon was outside while it was raining. By the time I came back, the moon is gone. But it's right there, people. It's right in this direction, and it's huge. Okay, people, it's huge. Within just 2 days, it's a phenomenon. Okay, the moon is right above this tree right here. And it's causing this thunder. The moon and the sun is causing these thunders. Because the moon, the sun is striking, it's sending lightning towards the moon. It's like... Hey people, Paul Michael here. August 10th, 2011. Here goes the moon. Look at that, how big it is, how fast it's getting to be a supermoon, people. Look how quickly it's becoming a supermoon, huh? I'll show it to you on the 8th. Right? Remember how it looked on the 8th when I showed it to you? Now look how fast it's getting. It's getting to be ripe. It's getting to be a supermoon. It's not going to come where I want it to come. It's too far away. But it's going to get a little bit closer though. I'm not giving up hope though. I'm still trying to get it to come between the gate. You know, I don't want to come between the gate. I'm still trying. But no sweat. What does that look like? What does that form, people? I don't know. Like a man with the sun on his back. His hand is... He's down. His hand is behind his back and up the whole of the moon. Just like a sculpture, I see. Don't pay me no attention, okay? I'm just being imaginative. You know, I could see a lion with this moon on his back.
Alright, that's all for now, folks. Actually, I'm going to climb back out.
Just about four. Today the 10th, so wow, huh? By the 12th, I have a super moon by the 12th. So people imagine that, right? The first super full moon was March 19th, 2011, the first one. Now it's coming on August 12th. So you see, the days are, it's like the days are what, shorter or longer? The nights are shorter, the days longer. That's what's going on, people, okay? Our world, it's like the world is speeding up, but we don't realize it. But if you watch the moon, you'll realize it, because the moon have to go through its cycle, okay? The moon cannot go around the moon cannot go through the cycle any faster than the earth is spinning. So if the moon is going through the cycle so quickly, it means that our earth is going through it quickly too, people, okay? We went from a full moon, super full moon, from March 19th, okay, to a super full moon by August 12th. That's a whole week faster. Because no matter that the day, some days are 20, are 30 and 31, that doesn't matter. The moon still going through its cycle. The moon still go through its full cycle, and this moon is going through its cycle so quickly. Okay, on Earth as it is in heaven. Okay. So if the moon is going so fast, it means the sun, it means that the Earth has speed up, and the sun and the moon has speed up. We are traveling at a faster pace, people. Okay? Just follow the moon, because they are for signs and seasons, okay? The moons are for days and nights and signs and seasons. So if we know that the moon, every 28 days, the moon goes from whatever, from a quarter to a full in 28 to 30 days. Okay, we know that for a fact. We know we had a we know that for a fact, right? And then you go from March 19th, okay, to August 12th. I mean, by tomorrow, say August 11th, because August 11th, it'll be full. By tomorrow, it's gonna be a full moon. So. But whether it's 11th or it's at 12th, it's still like a whole week. So, you telling me now the moon went to a cycle in 21 days? Going to a cycle in 21 days now? Hmm? So the months are 21 days now? Our Earth has speed up its rotation. Think about the people, and it's time for that we demand that our, well, that's a joke. I was gonna say to demand that the government tell us the truth, but that's a joke. The government is feeding the flock for slaughter. They're not telling us that somehow that we are broken some kind of gravitational pull. We are broken something. You know, and now follow the moon and you'll realize it. But our Lord, my Lord is so beautiful, like, he won't let us feel the effect, because we'll die. Okay? Don't you see, people, our consciousness is speeding up. Oh, I get it, people, I get it. our consciousness, we are awakening. So when we are awake, that means the earth is going fast, and that means our consciousness is awakening. That means we're going to a higher level. People, watch this, right? We are going to a higher level of understanding. The earth is speeding up its rotation. Just follow the moon and you'll be able to tell it. The moon is not supposed to be here today. The moon is supposed to be further west. Okay, I know because I've been tracking it for a while now. Okay? And the Sirius Orion belt have twisted a thing, people. I think this has twisted because last year July, right, Sirius was in the back, at the bottom of the Orion system. And people now, I see, sorry, I ran out of it shut off. Like I was saying, people, last July I saw Sirius, and Sirius was at the bottom, okay? The first star to rise was, it was actually Aldebaran, right? But however, Aldebaran is rising first now, but it's not different, it's not different direction, right? Sirius now it's twisted. It's not totally different from what I see so far. It's not totally different direction, people. I see Sirius is like it's in the front now. It's hiding behind the tree, but by the time the light comes up, right? By the time I can see it, the sun is up, so it blinks it out. It come behind this tree right here. But you can't see. But like I was saying, people, it looks to me like Sirius has twisted. Like Sirius is now at the top. Like, because Rigel was at the bottom with Sirius, and Betelgeuse was at the top of the cross. But now it looks like Betelgeuse is at the bottom now. But how could that be? Anyway, I'm gonna wait maybe another week or so, and I'll be able to tell you all. But something strange is going on. I'm not seeing things. Something's going on, people. And why is there something missing in Google Maps? That's what they hide in. Because Sirius is a winged planet. Okay, the rainbow planet is Sirius. Okay, that's the winged planet you all see next to the sun, the big one. That's Sirius. Okay. So, what is NASA hiding? Why is there a big blotch in Google Maps? Google that you can't see. So people, we had something dramatic went on in our world, and stay tuned for more, because I think that we are becoming enlightened. Okay, we are becoming in our true form, because we are children of the light. Okay, I think we are becoming, at least I know, I think I am. You know. You don't have to be physical, but spiritually, you know? So anyway, my battery is blinking, so I know it's about to die. And I'm gonna shut off right now. And hey people, by the way, do you all know that Jesus Christ was never born? I mean, I could prove, use the Bible, right? I'm gonna make a video. I'm gonna prove to you all in a video, right people? I promise you, no lie, my word. I will use the Holy Bible and I prove to you that it was impossible for Christ to have been born. You know why? Because the lineage was cut off with Solomon's son. That's where how Christ was never born. Because the son that Christ would have come from died as a child. Abijah. Abijah died as a child. So if Abijah died as a child, that means the lineage was cut. Abijah is the son of Solomon. So y'all start researching, and I'll make a little video soon to prove to you all that Christ, it was the impossibility for Christ to have been born, because the lineage was cut. Okay people? One love. Christ died, born and died for us. Wow, what a ridiculous concept.